Hi, I'm Jace.
Hi, I'm Burjo.
Hello, I'm Jolly, and I play guitar in Bad Omens.
Ooh, and we're at Knotfest Melbourne 2023.
What we did on the weekend review with a few interviews.
Yeah, so Bad Omens, first time in Australia?
It is, yeah. Playing and visiting, and first time, period.
You did the koala photo?
We did. Actually, we did. That was crazy. That was insane, because first you go on and you look at these little creatures and they're so suited out. They're so cool.
Yeah.
They're sitting there. But then it's like the line was pretty long for it. And I was like, I don't even need that. But man, am I glad I did. As soon as you just put your hands out and that little chunk just sits in your hand, that was the craziest
thing.
It's
cool, huh?
You just like start smiling. I saw the whole crew and everybody who did it, like they were just looking. And as soon as the koala hits there, they just start shining up. They were so
absolutely
cool.
They're kind of cute, but then they can get a bit.
Yeah, they're calm, but yeah.
Then they can go.
They're a good vibe.
So, Knotfest, a couple of sideshows, and then back to touring.
Back to 1 month off. April is going to be off, but we have a May to prep for, which is we are trying to like switch up the set list a little bit and whatnot. Cool. So, and obviously, we got to keep practicing all the time because we try to play as good as possible when we're out there. So, it's going to be nice, though, to be able to go home and chill for an actual minute. I heard today that we've been out for 6 months and we only have like 3.5 weeks at home.
Fuck.
For Chinatown. I was like, God damn, you fucking for real?
Road on the road.
Yeah.
That'll be the best.
And then it makes sense because when we're home, it's just like, what is this place? You know?
Yeah,
and then when you're out here, you're just like, this is it. Okay, this is normal.
Yeah. So it'd be good 3.5 weeks just to relax, reset.
Yeah, exactly. To play some fucking video games and, you know, chill.
What's a game?
I got it. We were home for 4 days before we got flying out here, and I actually ordered Hogwarts Legacy.
How are you traveling on it?
I like it, dude. I ended up in Slytherin, and like what we did. We technically did the whole like answer like completely honestly, and it's like, really, I'm a fucking Slytherin. It's really cool though. I like the game. I haven't gotten that far, obviously, just fucking four days of it, but I'm excited.
Yeah. Oh, see. Album last year.
Yeah.
Just launched.
It did.
TikTok
in the in the fall of last year, right? It was a huge boost for Just Pretend.
Yeah.
So that was cool.
You got the wave, like the massive army of fans now. They're very unique.
Hardcore.
They're good. It's great. It's been really cool. The TikTok thing really helped. We've been doing like, you know, I felt that we were doing great before that too, but then it really obviously
because you were on the ramp.
Yeah.
And then
helped us enormously. And then it also like bridged for a lot of people to find out about us. They heard like that song and then they checked the other ones out. And you can see that there's a lot of people coming out to the shows and they're really singing and they're into it. And it's
good.
It's awesome. It's it's everything I want.
Who was you two with? You had Make Them Suffer on your tour last year.
Yeah, correct,
yeah. Who else is on that tour?
It was Thousand Below, Make Them Suffer, and it was Dayseeker.
Yes.
And it was us.
Tick all the boxes. That's an awesome package.
It was really good. Yeah, it was
amazing. Complete sellout as well, every show, I'm pretty sure.
Every show was sold out, yeah. And then same thing happened in Europe. So up until we did that, we lost our first headliner of last year, it's been selling out only, which is good.
What are the room sizes like?
Huh?
How big are the venues?
Oh, it's been a little bit different. Like, I think the American one was definitely very appropriately sized. It was fine. It felt good and everything. Some places were, I guess, maybe a little bit too small, but sometimes there's just no more availability.
Yeah, it's like that's what there is in that scene.
And then the European one was also sold out, but unfortunately, that felt way too small. There was way too many people that couldn't get the tickets, and that's always, to me, a little bitter. So like I said, it's bittersweet. People keep saying like, well, you fucking sold out, aren't you fucking happy? Like, of course I'm happy about that, but I'm like more worried about I'm concerned about the people that couldn't get it.
It gives the FOMO though. You get bigger and bigger.
Yeah, and it's like, I just want to cater up because we're here. I want to cater to everyone who wants to see us, and I think it's someone's job to make sure that fucking happens and not put us in like a 300 cap when there's like fucking 4,000 tickets waiting to be sold shit like that, you know?
Yeah.
I heard it was like in Belgium or somewhere where it's like, I don't know what the cap was for that venue. I think it was 1,000 maybe. But they're like, there was 4,000 in line that couldn't get tickets. And I'm like, great. You know? That's just like I said, it's a bittersweetness. It's like, oh shit, that's awesome that there's so many. But then like, and we're just not playing. Like, we're playing for so, like, only 1,000 of them. That it could be so much more that we could have catered to. And that's, that, you know, we just have to come back and do it better. That's how it works. You do the little ones and then come back.
So, hey, guess what? We're four times the size now.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of coming back, like, we know this hasn't gone the best, this Australian tour.
Right.
Which doesn't need to be said, but is there going to be plans in motion to come back?
There's none in motion, but I feel like we absolutely have to. And just being here, honestly, we fucking all really like it here. We were here in Brisbane. We had a few days off before we did anything, and we were just like, it just felt good. It was just like, I mean, it was nice weather and all, and we hadn't seen the sun in a hot minute. But that might have added into it. But
getting winter mode.
Yeah, we just really like it. And then the first show was amazing. It was really cool. It was, I don't know what it was called, but it was just really sweet. And we had the meet and greet, and there's like, you can kind of tell how the people are at the meet and greet. And it was just hilarious, fucking fun, awesome vibing people. Yeah. So I was like, we were like kind of stoked on that. We're just like, that was a really good meet and greet. Like, you know, and the show also was awesome. And then just the unfortunate thing with the other side show where everything happened that day, it felt like, because like a light caught fire right before we went on.
Fuck.
And it stunk back green, even back to the green rooms. Yeah. And like, you know how just burning plastic sucks. And I could feel it that far away. And I was like, and I'm gonna go up and stand next to that fucking smoking thing now. Yeah. So I was like, it was just not good. And then I don't know if that had anything to do with Noah not, because he felt it like halfway through, and I could hear it a little bit. He was like, shit, he's having some issues.
Yeah.
And he was talking like to the side and what to do and whatnot. So no, we just pulled it through as much as we could on that one. And then now he's on rest mode.
Yeah.
And but he might be feeling better. So I'm it's just what you have to do.
That's it. That's all. But it's part of tour, and it's
it needs to be good. And if you can't do it, you shouldn't. That's how we are. Like, we don't want to go up and try to half-ass anything.
And then
his instrument is his voice. So, you know, if something is wrong with it, like, that's, we just have to make sure that it meant for the rest of the shows instead of going up and just ripping the heavy ones or something, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, it is what it is, but it's good to be here anyway.
It's not worth doing permanent damage or anything.
No, exactly. Like, you know, he's worried about everything. He's just very concerned taking this to effect first, like making sure that this is okay first. And I promise it's nothing. It's not us being lazy. It's not hungover.
After 6 months of touring, it's going to catch up sooner or later for a bit of a rest.
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like, it makes fucking sense. And this happens to everyone every once in a while. And it hadn't happened for us in years. So, shit, we just had to take the one now. Yeah. And then hopefully we're good for another 6 years or something. That's how it fucking goes. I'm not worried about it.
So we've got some normal questions we ask everyone.
I wouldn't say they're normal, but
yeah. Well, they're normal, but they're not normal.
Okay.
What's a weird tour story you've had?
A weird tour story?
Yeah.
These are like meet and greet questions, and I really have to think about.
Oh, meet and greets. Fantastic stories,
aren't you? No, man, you don't have no idea how like excluded, like we're very chill guys.
Yeah,
we're
yeah.
like, you know, we don't really like.
You've had no dramas though, like.
No,
what with a light catching fire at Sydney.
Oh, you mean like that?
I
mean,
like show dramas.
More than shit like that, or like.
You get up and your two songs in, like, oh, my guitar's not on. Like, sick.
Hey, I mean, everyone has everything. I'm not gonna, I'm not gonna admit to any of those, like, because literally, if something goes wrong, I pretend like nothing is wrong until my fucking tech fixes.
Like, hey, it's good. Fine.
Yeah, because like, I know that someone is on it, and it's not like. And then, like I said, this is a job like anyone else. Like, it's sometimes shit is wrong, and it's our job to make sure that as few people as possible notices it, and then like, and then just hop back into normal and not let that bother you. Like, not fucking stop the show and be like, hey, what are you doing? You know, like Elton John style or something, just so no, it's been good. We're running a pretty tight ship, so if anything is wrong, it's just a technical that we couldn't really anticipate or anything, you know.
What was the first show you ever went to?
The first show I ever went to was either CC Top.
Sick.
Or it was Toto. It was either one of
either way.
What
was that?
Fuck, it was far back. It's just one of the bands that my dad liked, and they were like, CC Top was fucking, no, CC Top was playing far up north. I'm from Sweden, actually, from the beginning, right? So they were playing far up north, and so I think it might have been Toto.
See?
And then in the second one was probably ZZ Top then.
Right.
Yeah. And I was, I don't know how long, it was probably like between 8 and 10 maybe.
Oh,
like
yeah.
That. Yeah.
Once your first show you paid for yourself?
The first show I paid for myself might have been Slipknot, man. It might have been. I remember this because they were playing a festival, or like, you know, they were on a festival. I don't know if they were headlining. I think Metallica was or some shit.
Yeah.
But they were on a festival in Sweden. I really wanted to go, but I was kind of too young for it.
Mm-hmm.
And I just told my mom, they're like, if you don't let me go, I'll take the fucking, I have a moped. So I was like, I'm going to take my moped and drive up. Yeah, yeah, exactly. It was like one of those things. And then she was cool. Because my brother was going, she was like, well, he will take you. And then, like, you can separate there as long as he, at least there's a family member there and all mm-hmm. that. So I was pretty young. I don't remember what. But, no, that was cool as fuck. I remember that. That was because, yeah, I was in the middle of the crowd, you know, they did the whole thing, like, and spit it out. Everybody sits down and then, like, fucking jumps up. And I'd seen, like, disaster pieces and shit from that. Yep. So I knew what was going on. Like, I knew what was going to happen. I was so stoked about it. And I remember, yeah, I remember, like, this one of those moments when Corey just throws a water bottle out and I got splashed.
Sick.
It's like, yeah, that was cool. Teenage Jolly like that. That was cool.
Yeah. So full circle. Now you're playing with Slipknot. So you played with, have you played with Slipknot before?
Have we played on a festival with them? Fuck, I wish my tour manager right here could have told you. I actually don't know. I feel like we might have, but yeah. I feel like we might have been on, or maybe it's been one of those things where we're like, we're on the same bill, but we're different days or something. Yeah, it's usually like that. And like a lot of bands that I want to see, it's just never on my day, like fucking Behemoth. Like I always never get to see them. And I was like, God damn, come on, I want to see some black metal.
Yeah.
But I can't say for sure. It just feels like I have though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's the one band that you've never seen that you want to see?
Yeah, it's AC/DC.
AC/DC.
Yeah, I'd love to see him. I don't know if
he's going to come back to Australia. They play here all the time.
Oh, you're fucking Akadaka. Dude, I hate that. I cannot take it. I thought it was a joke first, and I was like, there's no way I'm going to call him that ever.
That's just what everyone calls him.
That sounds so disrespectful.
They were playing it through the PA before, and I was like, fuck.
What are you going to call us in fucking 5 years? Biddy, Immy.
Well, I call you Bad Onions.
Oh, yeah, you do.
Bad Onions. Because the logo, the new logo, the N and the eye is like three lines.
Oh shit.
And it sort of looks like, I'm like, that's a
bad like, onion. Right.
Yeah, the M looks like an N and an I. I'm like, what's that? Bad Onions.
We were wondering if we were going to sneak the Bad Onions name in or not.
But yeah,
I don't love it.
You need a nickname.
Yeah, what about Bad Omens?
Just Bad Omens.
Yeah. That's why we fucking named it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
No, it's good. It's good. So, do you have your phone on you?
I actually gave it to my no, I don't. And also, I don't have service.
No one does. I was going to say, one of our standard questions, what's your Uber rating? But.
Oh, really? Oh, like what they rate me?
You can check it on the app and it'll tell you your star rating.
Really? Yes. I bet it's good though, man. I bet it's good.
We've had a lot of bands with bad numbers.
Really?
Yeah.
I should check that out because I've been on Ubers a lot. But I always give them like four.
Yeah.
You know?
I never rate.
So do,
unless they fucking suck, but I don't think I've ever had one that fucking sucks.
Well, we think that too. And then we look like, oh no.
Yeah, we got a few ones
you
in
give
there.
Them, you give them four and you give them a little tip and then like, you know.
Yeah. You hope so.
Have you caught an Uber with all your gear?
No.
So you might be all right then. It's the gear that puts you down.
No, I don't think I've been like inconveniently Ubering or like, you know, if like obviously they'll have to do what they have to do, but like if someone comes with like five bags and like can cram it in, I've never done anything like that. I've just, you know, going from place A to B.
Are you a convo person with the driver?
If they talk, I always reply. Yeah. I always like, I never engage and like, or like start it. No. But if they like, I can tell that he's a talky person. I'm not going to tell him like, hey, I don't really like to talk unless I really don't want to talk. I don't think I've never done that. Cause it feels weird. I'm just like, yeah, what do you have to say, bro? Like maybe he just wanted to fucking air some stuff. sometimes I have a really good conversation with one. I had one in London when I was, you know, going from my hotel to the venue, and this guy from, I think he said it was from Yugoslavia originally,
mm-hmm.
and he kind of gave me his fucking whole life story, dude. And we was like, he was a few years older than me, like five or something, but like he's lived a completely different life, and like he just talked about all that, and it was just, I was just kind of like being ears then, like, intrigued, and I was kind of good, like, I just had to chime in with some, oh, how was that? I'm like, blah, 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 you know, and it was like kind of a good story. So like, sometimes it's cool. Sometimes it's just bullshit. Sometimes it's like, what are you even talking about?
You
don't have really to fill the silences if you don't have anything good to say. But
yeah.
But yeah.
Do you like spicy food?
Love it.
What's your spice tolerance level?
Pretty high.
Yeah?
I mean, yeah, I'd say it's pretty high. I probably don't like compared to someone fucking means it, but
yeah. Out of 10.
It's maybe 8.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
like, you know, if you go to an Indian restaurant, it's always like different, like
I feel like
it's a proper Indian restaurant if the medium is pretty fucking spicy.
Yeah.
Because then if you go too strong, like, it's really intense.
Yeah.
And mild is like pretty mild, or you know. And in that range, I usually go medium because it feels like easier. Because you can ruin food with too much spice, for sure.
All right. I had breakfast this morning. It's still sitting bad.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, it's not delicious if it's all you can taste is fucking fire. But I like spicy.
Well, that's good. That's good.
I reckon mine wasn't even spicy, but everyone else would say it.
Pepper.
Killing me.
I gotcha.
No, that's about it. Yeah.
Cool.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you.
Bad Omens. Yeah, this will be out after the tour, so we can't even plug the tour.
All right.
But
hopefully we'll see you back real soon.
We'll see you back.
Yeah, thanks. I really hope so, too. Yeah.
Next year.
No, eventually. We'll see. You'll be back.
Yeah, absolutely. We will be back. I can tell you that for sure.
Yeah.
Real big venues, I think. Real big.
Very cool.
Yeah, fuck. So. Huge venues, actually.
I hope so, man. Yeah. I'm there for it. Small venues, big venues, give it to me.
It's happening.
Beautiful.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.